Hey friends, welcome to Get Sleepy, where we listen, we relax, and we get sleepy. As always, I'm your host, Thomas. Thanks for tuning in. Tonight's relaxing tale will be read by Jessica and was written by Alexandra. It takes place in Cantabria, in northern Spain. We'll join a teenage boy, Javier, on a lazy summer afternoon as he goes for a walk in the forest near his home. There's something magical about the atmosphere in this peaceful woodland, and although he thinks he's too old for fairy tales, he might just change his mind. So let's spend a moment settling in. Whatever today brought your way, you can leave it in the past and let your focus come into the present moment. This moment right here is filled with peace, calm, and serenity. Three beautiful words that tend to bring about precisely the feelings they describe when we hear them said, or when we repeat them in our own mind. So, as you allow your breathing to ease into a slow and steady rhythm, feeling your body relaxing into bed, just continue to repeat those three soothing words in your mind. Peace, calm, serenity. Just listen along to tonight's story, beautifully read by Jessica, maintaining that sense of peace, calm, and serenity. It takes place on a summer's day in the countryside of northern Spain. Let's begin.
Javier walked slowly through the sleepy village. He was on his way home from school. His backpack hung loose over one shoulder. It was lighter than usual, and he felt light too, knowing that the day was over. Today was Friday, and there was nothing he had to do. It was an unusually hot and humid afternoon, so maybe Javier would take a nap in his bedroom. The thought was tempting. He could close the shutters, turn on the electric fan by his bed, then spread out over the cool sheets. And there he would drift off, sleeping until late in the afternoon. Or instead, perhaps he could pass by his friend's house. One of his best friends from school lived in a house with a huge garden. It had a shady terrace and a swimming pool with the coolest, bluest water. In the summer, Javier often spent the afternoons at his friend's house. They would chat for hours, sitting together on the terrace, or floating in the pool. The thought of his friend's house was tempting too. But then, while he was walking down the street, Javier passed under a tree. Feeling the cool relief of the shade, he paused for a moment, and he had another idea. It had been a long time since he'd gone for a walk in the forest. On the edge of the village, not far from his home, was a beautiful woodland. As a child, he'd gone there all the time to play or explore. Now he was a teenager. His life was so busy. School took up most of his time, and on weekday afternoons he often had football practice. When he was free, he would usually see his friends, or he would help his parents in the village cafe where they worked. Today, however, he had no plans. He was free to do whatever he wanted. As he stood in the shade of the tree, Javier felt a trickle of sweat run down the back of his neck. First, he decided he would go to the cafe for an ice-cold soda. Then he would head to the forest and find a shady spot to sit and rest for a while. Maybe he would even take a nap beneath the trees. Happy with his plan, Javier ambled on through the village. He crossed to the shady side of the street. Many of the shops already had their shutters down. Here, most businesses closed after lunch and didn't open again till late afternoon. The cafe, which was owned by Javier's parents, was one of the few places still open at this time. Javier pushed open the door, causing the bell to tinkle. The room was cool, thanks to the ceiling fan whirring quietly overhead. Javier's father appeared from behind the counter, greeting him with a smile. "It was so hot today," said Javier's father. "On days like these, it was best to take it easy." Javier agreed. That was exactly what he intended to do. He explained his plan for the afternoon. At the mention of the forest, Javier's father grinned. "Make sure you keep an eye out for the fairies," he said. This was an ongoing joke between the two of them. According to folklore, the woods in this region were inhabited by fairies, known as the Anjana. These benevolent creatures were believed to be the forest guardians. When Javier was little, he and his father had often gone for walks in the woods together. As they wandered through the trees, Javier's father would point out traces of the forest fairies. A fallen feather on the ground, an unusual shape on a tree trunk, or dazzling sunlight among the leaves. According to Javier's father, any of these things could be a sign that the fairies were among them. Javier was too old for such stories now, but he liked to humor his father. Of course, said Javier. I'll let you know if I see anything. Talking made him realize just how thirsty he was. So he went to the fridge filled with drinks in the corner of the room. Opening the fridge door, he relished the cool blast of air. He took his time scanning the shelves, undecided which soda to choose. Eventually, he picked out a fizzy lemon drink in a bright yellow can. For Javier, it was the taste of childhood. A drink he associated with birthday parties, picnics, and days at the beach. I'll add it to the tab, said Javier's father. This was another one of his jokes. Javier could have anything he wanted from the fridge. Of course he didn't have to pay. Taking a pack of chewing gum from the counter, he winked at his father. See you later, said Javier. The bell tinkled once again as he walked out the door with the chewing gum in his pocket and the soda can in his hand. It felt so deliciously cool against his skin. Walking down the street, Javier opened the can with a hiss and took a sip. It was just as he remembered, a refreshing burst of lemon that fizzed on his tongue and cooled his throat. The soda relieved his thirst in an instant. And all of a sudden, the afternoon no longer felt quite so hot. All the same, Javier was happy to reach the forest just 10 minutes later. By that point, he'd already finished every drop of the soda. As well as cooling him down, the drink had given him a welcome lift in energy. Javier tossed the empty can in a bin near the forest entrance. Then he stepped into the shade of the elm trees and entered another world. The feeling was wonderfully familiar. Every time he visited the forest, he felt a sense of peace wash over him. His heart rate slowed, and his breathing became slower too, and deeper. Among the trees, the air was cool and fresh. He took a deep breath in, savoring all the scents of nature. It hadn't rained for a while, and the earth beneath his feet was hard and dry. Even so, he could still smell the fragrance of the forest. The calming aroma of the leaves, soil, and wildflowers all mixed together. Javier wandered down a trail he had followed many times before. He knew this area so well that he didn't even need to think about where he was going. Movements felt instinctive here. It was like returning home and moving from room to room without thinking. And although Javier was walking through the forest alone, he reflected that it would be impossible to feel lonely here. Wherever he went, the birdsong kept him company. And somehow, when he listened to the birds, it was as though his father was there with him. Hearing the sweet chirping that echoed through the trees, Javier could hear his father's voice too. "That sounds like a firecrest," he would say. "And that's a nightingale, of course." Javier's father knew all the names of the birds and the trees. Walking deeper into the forest, Javier tried to identify the trees that he passed. Most of these were oaks, he thought. Then there were the elms, the birches, and the lindens. To Javier, all these trees had a presence of their own. They kept him company too, just like the birds. Surrounded by their ancient, solid trunks, he felt safe and protected, cocooned from the rest of the world. There was something unusual about the layout of the trees in this forest. They almost seemed to be arranged in circles. Following the path towards the heart of the forest, Javier imagined that he was moving through rings or layers of trees. A map of the forest trees might resemble the interior of a cut tree trunk. The circular layout was just like the concentric rings inside a trunk. Perhaps it was this that put Javier in such a relaxed, dreamy mood as he walked on. It was like being hypnotized. Or maybe, he thought, he was just sleepy from the heat. Soon he would find somewhere to sit and rest for a while. All the same, the magical atmosphere of the forest was undeniable. There was something in the air, as if it was charged with some kind of invisible energy. It was no wonder, thought Javier, that this forest had inspired myths. He had grown up hearing stories of the Anhana, the forest spirits. These fairies watched over the woodland, protecting the trees, the animals, and any human visitors who happened to be passing through. They were known to be kind, caring for any living creature who was hurt or who lost their way in the woods. And they were generous, sometimes sharing their riches with humans. According to some stories, the Anhana lived in tree trunks or in underground grottos which were filled with treasure. In other tales, the fairies dwelled in woodland springs or streams. Javier knew that they were only stories, of course. He had never seen a fairy, and none of his friends or family claimed to have encountered one. If the Anhana resembled the illustrations in books, it would be easy. They were usually depicted as beautiful young women with crowns of wild flowers and ribbons in their hair. The fairies carried golden staffs and wore shining tunics, and their transparent wings glittered too, like church windows in the sunlight. If the Anhana appeared in this form, they would be unmistakable. Anyone who encountered a winged woman in the forest would know exactly what they had just seen. but no one that Javier knew had ever seen a winged woman. If fairies existed, they were most likely shapeshifters. "Don't look for wings," Javier's father had told him once as they walked through the forest together. "Look at the trees and listen for the song of the nightingale." The Anhana were believed to take other forms. Sometimes they were trees, insects, or birds. Javier smiled at this thought. Perhaps the fairies were all around him right now, and he had no idea. He didn't believe in the Anhana, but he didn't disbelieve. He liked to keep an open mind about such things. One day, if he ever had children, he would tell them the same stories about the Anhana. And they would explore the forest together, just like Javier had explored with his father. His mind was wandering now. He could feel his thoughts becoming soft and dreamy as the sleepiness came over him in waves. When he reached the stream, Javier decided to stop and rest. He found the ideal spot where he could lean against the vast trunk of an old oak tree. The ground was soft and comfortable, and here in the shade, the temperature was just perfect. Javier closed his eyes. He could hear nothing but the birds and the flowing water of the stream. This had to be the most peaceful place in the whole of this enchanted forest. He felt so relaxed, so at ease, and so sleepy. With his head resting gently against the tree, Javier drifted into sleep. Even while he was sleeping, he had a vague awareness of time passing. And he could sense things, like patches of warm sunlight on his bare arms, or the chirping of the birds. He seemed to be slowly drifting in and out, dipping down into sleep, then shifting into a kind of waking trance. At some point, he opened his eyes. He could still feel the rays of sun moving across his body, gently warming him here and there. Looking up, he saw where the light was shining through the leaves above. But it wasn't sunlight. It had a different color, like silver mixed with gold, glittering at the edges. And when he looked down at his body, he noticed something unusual about the patches of light and shadow. They didn't look like the patterns created by sunlight through the leaves. Instead, his body was covered in glowing circles of gold and shadows that resembled butterflies' wings. It felt like he was bathing in magic rays. The mysterious dance between light and shade went on and on, filling him with a sense of deep contentment. He was both warm and cool, asleep and awake. Then, once again, he became aware that time had passed. Perhaps an hour, or perhaps only a few seconds. But when he awoke this time, he noticed the sounds. At first, they seemed to be the same as before. The birds chirping, and the flowing water of the stream. But no, the sounds weren't quite the same. Listening carefully, he could hear voices. The birdsong transformed into syllables, then words in another language. And the water was speaking too, or laughing, singing. They were the sweetest sounds. And just like the light and shade, they gave him a sense of happiness and well-being that he could not explain. All he knew was that he was filled with the deepest joy. And within him, there was that familiar feeling that he was not alone. He was surrounded by a loving presence. Here in the forest, he was safe and protected. They were looking after him. Sometime later, Javier awoke from his nap. He rubbed his eyes and stretched his arms. Then he remembered what he had seen. The glowing lights and the patterns of wings moving across his arms, his chest, and his legs. He must have dreamt it. But in his heart, he felt a wonderful sense of certainty. It was not just a dream. He knew what he had seen, heard, and felt. But even now, he was not fully awake. It took Javier a few moments to return to reality, as he gradually became aware of his surroundings. Up above, he could hear the birds singing to one another. The melody was as beautiful as before. Or perhaps it was even lovelier. He remembered the sound of the voices, that mysterious language he'd heard when he was sleeping, or only half awake. Then he turned his gaze to the stream beside him. It flowed on with that sweet, refreshing sound. But now it seemed even sweeter, even more soothing. He recalled the other voices, the words mixed with laughter and joyful song. Now Javier knew that the Anhana were real. In one form or another, the fairies existed. It was something he now believed instinctively. Although he couldn't explain it, He just knew it to be true. And with this knowledge, he felt a new sense of peace and contentment. Of course, he reasoned, maybe this feeling was simply the result of a nap. He had slept so well. His body felt completely rested, and his mind was calm and clear. In a moment, he would get up and begin the short walk home. The temperature was cooler now in the late afternoon. The air was even lighter, fresher. Javier took in a deep breath, then let out a happy sigh. That evening, he would talk to his father, and he would tell him what he had discovered. That there really was some kind of magic in the woods.